Thank you. May you bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us together tonight in celebration of the graduates here before us. We are blessed that you have allowed us to find such time in a chaotic period in our lives to recognize the achievements and triumphs these graduates have seen throughout their school years. We are grateful for a return to normalcy after the past few years, and will always cherish the many memories we've made together during our years at DHS. We thank you for giving our scholars minds that have set high academic standards and surmounted seemingly insurmountable obstacles. We are grateful for the strength you have given to our athletes, who through you have been able to set new records and push the boundaries of what they once thought was possible. Most of all, we thank you for the hearts that you've bestowed upon each one of our graduates, allowing them to spread the love to others that you so graciously give to them. As these graduates move into the real world, whether that be starting a job, furthering their education, or serving our country, we pray that you give them the resilience and tenacity to stand up to the challenges they are faced with. We hope that you will continue to guide them forward in their lives so that they may do good in your name. Help them find light in the darkness and to open their hearts and minds to the many things that this world you have created has to offer. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining the class of 2022 in the celebration of our 13 years of schooling. While these years have been fun, I'd be lying if I said they were easy. Many challenges were thrown our way, the first being how we wanted to express ourselves. School is often viewed as a place to learn academically. However, school offers the opportunity for students to find out who they are and how they want to present themselves. Juggling with this self-identity is no easy task. It led to bullying, mean comments, and insecurity. Yet, the struggle did not define the class of 2022. We learned about our passions and morals, our future endeavors and careers. Though our seeds were just beginning to sprout as we entered high school, we have now blossomed into self-aware graduates who are ready for their next chapter. In the face of challenge, we showed resilience and we showed strength. But let's not forget about the true hardships of school: homework, assignments, and tests. Late nights at the table studying for a test began to catch up with the overflowing agenda of extracurriculars. Personally, I know there were times where I wanted to throw in the towel and let myself succumb to the pressure. Was the test on something I will never use in the future really that important? And despite these notions, I and my classmates alike picked ourselves up from defeat, dusted off our feelings of giving up, and finished our work. Once again, the class of 2022 had shown resilience in the face of adversity. And how could we forget about 2020 when we had to move into a new school and adapt to a virtual classroom setting? Yet, the change in setting and learning still did not deteriorate the class of 2022's determination to make it here today. This strength, however, is not something that is learned alone. We must all be taught. Luckily, we had the best teachers of all, our parents and guardians. From the day we were born, our parents and guardians have been in our corner, cheering us on. They came to every game you played. They came to your first orchestra concert where they sat listening to high-pitched squeals that they told you sounded amazing despite the clear lack of skill, and they stood up for you when you couldn't stand up for yourself. And during their devotion to our progress, there were times where we were not always the kindest. We rolled our eyes at chores, argued with them about stuff we did not know, and worst of all, felt embarrassed being seen around them. They endured our hormonal changes and teen angst, only to be there when we realized that our parents and guardians are not perfect, but they are our biggest fans. Though through these changes, our parents remained resilient. They did not give up on us when we gave up on them. When I look back at the times I was disrespectful to my parents, I appreciate that they always loved me despite my flaws. They taught me that all relationships may have rough spots, but you have to be strong and fight through them, because in the end, you care for that person and they care for you. I do want to say a special thanks to my family. I know I was not the easiest kid to raise, but thank you for always being there. I love you guys and I hope I make you proud. Like I said earlier, the school environment gave me the opportunity for the class of 2022 to develop socially, but also allowed another family to be created, the teachers and staff of our school. I think that the strength these people show is often overlooked. Imagine having hundreds of teens who are angry at the world and trying to teach them something they're uninterested in. I can promise you that is not always the most delightful concoction. Despite the late assignments we turn in, the lack of effort we most show in class, or the disgust we present when giving another assignment, they kept on teaching us. They kept on trying to form relationships. To care so much about someone's education despite their attitude towards you is the definition of resilience. They have no obligation to make the classroom engaging, but they desire to make us successful people who will contribute back to the community. I want to thank all of my prior teachers. Thank you for fostering my growth, and thank you for putting up with my random off-topic discussions that add nothing to the lesson we were learning. I hope I can someday use the knowledge you gave me to help the world become a better place. Thanks to our teachers and parents, we, the class of 2022, have been able to graduate as strong, resilient scholars. Our futures are very bright, but we will face challenges. Life can be hard, but we have the tools and support to fight off these struggles and triumph. Let the resilience and strength we have learned over our schooling lead us into our next endeavors. Our parents and teachers believe in our success, but the only person who has the power to make that happen is ourselves. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce four members of the class of 2022 who will be delivering commencement addresses this evening. Will Alex Byers please come forward? Alex is the daughter of Robert and Chris Byers. She will be attending Kent State University this fall to pursue a degree in psychology, minoring in political science with the hopes of becoming a pediatric health psychologist. Erin Callantine will follow Alex. Erin is the son of Todd and Jennifer Callantine. Erin will be heading to West Virginia University to study biochemistry on a pre-med track. Following Erin, Grace Williams will speak. Grace, the daughter of Jeff and Tania Williams, will embark on studies of English literature with a co-major in pre-medical studies at Miami University this fall. Our final speaker will be Jenna Ziegler. Jenna is the daughter of Jeff and Becky Ziegler. She will be attending the University of Akron this fall to major in criminal intelligence analysis and minor in Spanish. It is my privilege to welcome Alex, Erin, Grace, and Jenna to speak this evening. First and foremost, I would like to thank the parents, family members, friends, teachers, administrators, coaches, and staff that have all gotten us to where we are today, sitting here wearing our caps and gowns. Class of 2022, we did it. We're here. Our graduation day has finally arrived. We have been waiting for this day since we first walked through the doors of the old DHS as tiny little freshmen who knew absolutely nothing. And if you were like me, you've been counting down the days since the end of junior year. But now that the day is finally here, I'm sad that it is, because it means leaving teachers who have become mentors, friends who have become family, and the place that has motivated us to become the young adults we are today. While I was brainstorming what I wanted my speech to be about, no matter what topic or idea I thought of, I kept getting this overwhelming feeling. For a while, I couldn't seem to place what that feeling was. But then one day it hit me. It was the feeling of insurmountable gratitude that I had the serendipitous luck of being a Dover tornado with the wonderful and inspiring people who make up the class of 2022. Once I was able to place this feeling, I instantly knew what I wanted to speak about. Now, I'm about to use an anaphora, so Mrs. Wallach, wherever you are in here, I hope you're proud of me. Dover is the place where we learned our ABCs and how to write in cursive. Dover is the place where we formed our first friendships. Dover is the place that saw our awkward phases. Dover is the place where we found our passions, whether that be science or history, baseball or cheerleading, playing the violin, or performing on stage. Dover is the place where you can run into your second grade teacher 10 years later, and she still greets you with the same warm smile and hug she did when you first entered her classroom. Dover is the place where we chant "Beat, beat, Philly," and we usually do. Dover is the place where coaches and teachers willingly spend more time with their athletes and students than they do their own families. Dover is the place where we learn to be hardworking, determined, respectful, and compassionate individuals, whether it have been through watching our peers or by observing how our teachers pushed us and handled even the toughest days with grace. Dover is the place that we call home. Though Dover is the place we call home, it is time for all of us to spread our wings and head out into the real world. We must leave our safety net of small little Dover and begin to chase our dreams that were fostered here. I sincerely hope each and every one of you achieve your goals and get everything you want out of life, while also being the people our Dover community has raised us to be and would be proud of us for being. So, my last remark to my fellow graduates comes from what I wrote to myself in my seventh grade letter. Be extraordinary and congratulations. We are finally graduating. Thank you.
Thank you, Alex. I'd like to start by thanking each and every one of you, students, guardians, teachers, parents, administrators, for getting us here today. These 200-some chairs would not be filled if it were not for all of you. I believe this class of 2022 is special, and I know every generic speech says that, but truly, I think it. We have students who are going to be hired straight into the workforce, some going to the military, and most continuing their athletic and academic careers in college. That alone is proof of how successful this class is going to be. I truly think each individual's future is going to be something special. These past 13 years have been great in the Dover School District. Although we have all of our critiques, I can confidently say that I would not have rather gone anywhere else. Growing up around great culture, athletics, and academics is all we could have asked for. The things that this community does for students of Dover and the programs in which we participate in is insurmountable. I speak for all students when I say this. We're grateful. Grateful for the endless support, countless donations, and most importantly, your students. Parents, time went quick, didn't it? It may seem like we were being swaddled just yesterday by some of you. My friends, it's about time, isn't it? Growing up together has been every ounce of fun, but we're moving on, going into what is unknown to us. Some may be fearful for what it entails, others of us ecstatic. No matter what you're feeling tonight or in the coming future, find what you love. And that is true for work, as is your lovers. Work is going to encapsulate a large portion of your life. And the only way to be truly satisfied with your work is to do great work. And the only way to do great work is to do what you love. And if you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. I could stand up here and recount so many memories, like the time that I got pulled over with 20-some-odd people in my truck playing Running Man. I hope that everyone here tonight remembers the past 13 years like I do. Every possible memory. We've all seen it. A pandemic, arguably the worst political turmoil ever, the peak of technology, whatever you want to say. Living through a pandemic is quite literally once in a century thing, but we did it. We really only had 2 years of high school, freshman and senior year. The other two were spent at home or half online, half here. And I'm proud of each student and how we have managed to make it through all of that to be sitting in these chairs today. As we're traveling into the next chapter of our lives, I want to leave everyone with a piece of advice. Forgive, but do not forget. There's no sense in living with hatred in your heart. Living with hatred leads to discontent. And nobody likes being unhappy, but if you do, that's cool, I guess. And bringing those who have done you wrong forgiveness will bring closure, not only to yourself, but also to them, even if you don't realize it. It makes both parties feel better. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Grace Williams, and I am honored to be speaking to you all today. Those who know me know that I love to read, and I like to think that every person's life story can be thought of like a book. In my experience, all the best books start with a strong foundation in the first few chapters. So I would like to start by taking some time to recognize the many people that have already played a part in the life stories of the class of 2022. First, we would not be where we are today without the love and support of our parents. Every step of the way, they have been there to lift us up and help us achieve everything we set our minds to. They have always been our biggest cheerleaders. Even after the night spent playing Candy Crush in the car for hours while waiting to pick us up from late practices and rehearsals. Second, deserving of our recognition are the teachers and staff at Dover, who come every day and devote themselves to helping us to be the best people that we can be. And yes, while we definitely appreciated the times when they extended due dates for big assignments, what is truly special about our teachers and staff are the way that they connected with us on a daily basis and showed us that what we think is important. Another group that should be acknowledged is the community of Dover. From the T-ball coaches who introduced our three-year-old selves to sports, to the Girl Scout troop leaders and church youth group pastors, and countless others, many of our experiences over the last 18 years would not have been possible without the support of everyone in the community of Dover who have offered their time to help us grow and learn. Finally, our life stories are filled with pages about our fellow graduates who we have had the pleasure of getting to know over the last 13 years. We have all seen each other grow up, and we have been connected through practices, rehearsals, events, meetings, and classes. No one will ever know us in the same way that we have gotten to know each other, and that bonds us together in a way that might not always be apparent, but is strong. It has been an honor watching you all grow into the people that you are today, and I know that I would not be the same person you see up here without all of you. As we turn the page to the next chapter of our lives, we are going to start having more independence than we have had before, and we're also going to get to make choices that we have never made before. For example, Mom, I'm going to warn you right now that I might not always grab a jacket when it says it's going to be cold outside, so I'm sorry. However, making new choices also comes with making mistakes. That's all right, though, because mistakes aren't failures, but chances to learn and grow. Maybe it takes us an hour to drive somewhere close by because we took 20 wrong turns and Google Maps isn't loading. That just means that next time we'll make sure that we set the directions beforehand. Maybe. If you're like me, then probably not. In all seriousness, though, the important thing to remember is that this time is our opportunity to learn important life lessons and expand our horizons. Furthermore, while we embark on these next few chapters of our lives, it is important to always believe in ourselves. There is no one else in the world who is like you, and that means that no matter what, you have something special to offer that no one else does. After graduation, not all of our lives are going to look the same, but that's okay, because as long as we do what we know is right for us, we'll be able to go out in the world and represent Dover in the best way possible, by being ourselves. In conclusion, the stories of this graduating class have been interwoven for many years as we shared experiences throughout elementary, middle, and high school. To everyone hearing this today, I would like to take a personal moment to thank you all for playing a role in my story. Wherever our lives take us, you will always be inscribed in the first chapters of my life. As we continue writing our life stories, I hope that the class of 2022 remembers what an honor it is to be a Dover Tornado, and that there will always be a home here for you in Dover, Ohio. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to say thank you for coming to support us seniors tonight and celebrate our graduation from Dover High School. The past 4 years of our lives have been nothing short of eventful. As a class, we have grown and changed together, and we continue to make great strides towards the next adventure of our lives. We cannot forget where we have come from. As I sat down to write this speech, I thought about the different things that I could say, but I did not want it to be a cliche and further emphasize that our time is now. We know that our time is now. But let us take a few moments to reflect upon the past 4 years of our lives at Dover High School together. We may have had one of the craziest high school experiences. We went to school during construction and a pandemic, but one thing remained the same throughout all 4 years, our community. A few months ago, I had a substitute teacher remind us of how lucky we are to have grown up in Dover. I started thinking about this, and she's right. We have been so lucky to have a community that has supported our schools to provide us with a great education and a great environment. We have a new school and great teachers. Our school picks us up when we fall, encourages us to try again. When I was asked to speak at graduation, Mrs. Bache almost spoke for me and told them, yes, I would do it. But she decided to ask me and proceeded to tell me that if I said no, we were going to have a talk about why I do not want to do it and why I should do it anyway, although I said yes before she had to. This is a prime example of the teachers that we have access to in our high school. I have felt supported in all of my endeavors and pushed to achieve all of my goals. I never understood how important the Dover difference was until I reflected upon it. The Dover difference is the support that we receive from our community. The Dover difference is the support that we receive from our teachers. The Dover difference is the support that we have for each other. While I'm internally grateful for all of the support that our school and community has to offer, I think we need to remind ourselves that the next chapter of our lives is going to be a bigger change than any of us may realize. I read a quote that has stuck with me, and I would like to share it. Risk, then, is not just part of your life. It is life. The place between your comfort zone and your dream is where life takes place. It's the high anxiety zone, but it's also where you discover who you are. There is so much to take away from this quote, but my largest takeaway is to quit holding myself back for the fear of risk. My message to you today, my fellow classmates, is to take the support that this community has given us and move forward with the next chapter of our lives. We have been given the education and the resources to take the risk. As we rush off with excitement and anxiety to our next adventure in different cities, know this community will be supporting us along the way. For the final time, I would like to thank all of you in our community for supporting us and giving us the foundation to take on the next chapter of our lives with the confidence and support to chase our dreams. As we celebrate our graduation tonight, I would like us all to keep in mind how thankful we should be to have made it through our high school with this community behind us. And to my fellow graduates, congratulations, we have made it.
this time, I would like to welcome Mr. Michael Studer, Dover City Schools Board President, to say a few words to our graduates. Mr. Studer, please come forward.
Graduates, I was likely not as bright as you when I graduated from Dover in 2002. I struggled to even comprehend the word commencement. I figured it meant end, the end of my high school career. I learned years later the meaning of the word commencement was actually the beginning. We are celebrating the next chapter of your lives, the beginning of your lives as adults. Your next steps will vary greatly. Some will go straight into a career, while others will go to college or trade school. A few brave ones will even go to the military. Thank you. Some of you may not know what is next, and that's okay for now. Just keep searching. But whatever you do, I want you to be successful. Professional success to me is being free, doing what you want to do, the best you can do it, while helping others along the way. Now it is my distinct duty as board president to give you a few pieces of advice on how to become successful. Advice number one, prove them wrong. Prove them wrong. I have a quick story for you to illustrate this concept. 20 years ago, I graduated from Dover. I couldn't tell you who gave the commencement speech. In high school, I made poor decisions and my priorities were wrong. A scholar, I was not. In high school, I slept through most classes. When I was awake, it was a major distraction. Teachers had to hate me, some of whom are here tonight. My GPA for the last 9 weeks of my senior year was a 0.08. I think I got 1 D-. I knew I couldn't get a non-compete or I wouldn't graduate. I received the award of worst case of senioritis for the most days missed of any senior that year. Most teachers would have bet their pensions that I would not amount to anything. And you know what? The betting odds were definitely in their favor. I was destined for failure and reminded of it often by many. Somehow, I started college at Kent Branch, and my underperformance continued. Then one day, I met an academic advisor. He asked me to choose a major. I said, I want to be an accountant. He giggled to himself. They won't even let you in a program with grades like that, Mike. That would hit home. I could have accepted that and dropped out. Many people expected me to fail. I was even starting to believe it myself. But instead, I turned all that doubt into fuel for success. I retook the classes through freshman forgiveness. I obtained a 4.0 from that point forward every semester. I crushed the CPA exam. I received a master's degree in a science of accountancy. I started and sold many businesses. I became successful against all odds, against the opinions and words of many. Don't ever let the opinions of others define your future, even if your decisions were what made them feel that way. We all make mistakes. We all grow and mature at different rates. We all can change. And we all can prove them wrong. The second piece of advice I have for you is this. Have faith in yourself and the balls to prove it. That's right, I just said balls at your commencement ceremony. It was a calculated risk. Some things never change, teachers. Tom? Have the faith and have the balls. Metaphorically speaking, of course. have to believe in you first. You have to believe in you first. No one can do that for you. If you can't tell you that you believe in you, then lie to yourself until you do. Whatever you want to accomplish, create a plan, believe in yourself, have the courage to take that first step. Execute, fail, and repeat. You will fail at times. So what? Get back up and execute again. All right, let's wrap this up. In summary, number one, prove them wrong. Let your haters fuel your fire to succeed. Number two, have faith in yourself and the courage and balls to prove it. Thank you for your attention, students. May God bless your future endeavors and all you do.
There is no way to follow that other than with diplomas. Thank you. Honestly, that was one of the best I heard. Thank you, Mr. Studer. I mean it. Thank you. And young people, he came back to Dover and gave back to his community. Okay, let's get to it. Welcome to Dover High School, Class of 2022 Commencement. Parents and friends, you may step down to the gym floor directly behind the graduates as your graduate receives his or her diploma and the class flower. However, when finished, please move back into the seating area quickly to allow others an opportunity to take pictures as well. In addition, a professional photographer is currently taking pictures of the graduates and will contact you regarding these pictures. We would ask that you assist us in maintaining a dignified and respectful manner toward all graduates during the ceremony. To allow family and friends to enjoy the moment, please hold all applause and cheering until all graduates are announced. At the conclusion of the ceremony, permit the graduates to leave the facility by keeping the exit area open. Parents, family members, guests, Board of Education members, teachers, and staff, it is with great honor that I present to you, as candidates for graduation, the members of the Dover High School Class of 2022. Mr. Board President, the candidates listed and presented to the Dover City School Board have completed the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dover City School Board. Therefore, in accordance with the laws of the state of Ohio, I recommend that the Dover Board of Education, as evidence of their accomplishment, present each candidate with a diploma. In addition, receiving diplomas this evening are Reese Johnson and Ryan McVicker. They are participating in a state qualifying track meet at Pickerington North. Gina Franks, Director of Student Services and member of the East District OHSAA Board of Directors, is presenting Reese and Ryan their diplomas in Pickerington this evening. We congratulate Reese and Ryan. Mr. Michael Studer, President of the Board of Education, will come forward to present the diplomas. Mrs. Sarah Nottingham and Mr. Tom Morris will read the roll of candidates for graduation. Would the first row of candidates please stand?
Matthew Ryan Howell. Nevin Marley Wise. Alex Marie Byers. Aaron Joseph Callantine. Grace Elaine Williams. Jennifer Nicole Ziegler. Emma Arlene Andrews. Grace Elizabeth Basso. Jordan Ashley Rilhart. Catherine Ann Bruno. Emma Christine Cameron. Jaden Lynn Corley. Kara Riley Detweiler. Maisie Roselle Duggar. Samantha Ray Fry. Hannah Grace Graziani. Todd Fulman Howell. Jonathan Isaac Ure. Tori Elizabeth Jones. Tyler Andrew Little. Taylor Diane Luneborg. Ryan Taylor Nixon. Jacob Thomas Peltz. Daniel Henry Piper. Daniel Paul Pilcher. Cohen Michael Schwang. Jaden Franklin Steed. Mason Andrew Stoll. Alexandra Sean Thompson. Stephen Reese Utter. Allison Joe Bassbinder. Audrey Elizabeth Wallach. Julia Marie Weaver. Karis Ann Atkins. Audrey Christina Aljancic. Ty Jonathan Amos. Lee Allen Arbogast. Connor Riley Fix. Lydia Mary Frank. Samuel Isaac Garman. Gavin Michael Gerber. Daniela Gomez Rodriguez. Cesar Juan Gonzalez Sica. Liam Sebastian Griselli. Zoe J. Grimwood. Aiden Richard Hall. Riley Nicole Hanegraaff. Araya Sue Hardy. Blake William Harmon. Michaela Elise Haver Minoki. Jordan Todd Easton. Allie Mae Heisel. Samuel Benjamin Adam Hitchcock. Alexander Kenneth Hoffman. James Elliott Houston. Carson Zachary Howard. Feliciana Jessica Itzep Santiago. Asia Marie Johnson.
Michaela Aline Royer. Austin Wayne Jones. Jacob Paul Jones. Graydon Michael Capper. Nolan Thomas Kelliker. Brandon Michael Kaiser. Morgan Elizabeth Kaiser. Riley Paige Kohler. Ethan Daniel Kopp. Marcy Nicole Lauver. Emma Lynn Leeper. Dominic Mauricio Marini. Tristan Diana Martin. Grant Nathan Mastrio. JL Eileen McDade. Connor Drew McGarry. Carson James McKean. Cody James McPeak. Nicholas Matthew Mangus. Priya McKenna Metcalf. Abigail Lynn Metz. Xander Thomas Milburn. Ty Daniel Miles. Chase Colleen Miller. Coda Ryland Miller. Thomas Clarence Molk. William Blair Michael Moore. Zoe Lynn Mulliman. Dax Jacob Mullen. Jacob Allen Murphy. Parker Daniel Newland. Caitlin Marie Nitz. Caden Thomas Northrup. Sarah Elizabeth Novak. Stephanie Marie Novak. Manning James Orr. Jonathan Henry Osborne. Joaquin Osorio Raimundo. Reese Erica Palmatier. Olivia Renee Patton. Calum Von Allen Peltier. William Everett Pivato. Leah Rose Poole. Ava Rose Reber. Aaliyah Renee Reynolds. Lillian May Robertson. Gabriel Joseph Ola Roberts. Kansas Nicole Robin. Nathan Dwayne Rodocker. Peyton Elise Schweitzer. Shaylin Sky Scepter. Laura Ann Sexton. Austin Michael Schaefer. Brandon Lee Shepler. Emily Elizabeth Showers. Cameron James Sika. Cohen Michael Sinkovich. Brayton Alessandro Smith. Chance Donovan Smitley. Carol Ann Snyder. Chelsea Mariah Snyder. Leslie Angelica Solis Chell. Sierra Marie Staley. Kalechi Austin Arafu Stevenson. Riley John Stewart. Emily Elizabeth Stillwell. Gunnar Cole Stutzman. Emily J. Summerson. Gavin Drake Swiger. John Paul Telly. Troy William Thompson. Harry Charles Ernest Tolhurst IV. Noah John Tristano. Elizabeth Rose Vassbinder. Madison Renee Wagner. Milena Marie Wallach. Blake Irvin Warner. Tyler James Watson. Hannah Sharon Nicole Weekly. Caden Xavier Wells. Logan Allen Wenger. Austin J. Wirtz. Seth Charles Wisentainer. Jacob Friend Yoho. And in absentia, Braden Allen Crone, Colton Marcus Humbert, Reese McKenzie Johnson, Riker Osborne Kissel, Jackson Stephen Katajarvi, Matthew Edward McNutt, Ryan Matthew McVicker, Elliot Jackson Metz III, Logan Thompson Miller, Richard Declan Patterson, Alan Kevin Raimundo, Riley Jane Reynolds, Katarina Elizabeth Shuba, Benjamin Richard Stouffer, Ethan Alexander Latrell Swanger, Joshua Nicholas Thunberg, Scarlett Ava Wagner, Corey James Watkins, Nevaeh Michelle White, and Keegan Riley Witter.
Would the graduating class of 2022 please rise? To signify your new status as graduates of Dover High School, please move your tassel from the right to the left. I present to you the Dover High School class of 2022. And please join the class of 2022 as they sing the Dover High School alma mater. Page 4 inside the program contains the words.
May everyone please bow your heads to join me in our closing prayer. Dear gracious and loving Father, no matter how many times we all say thank you, it will never satisfy for all the gracious doings you have done for us. You have blessed us with many different gifts and talents, so help us use them for your glory. Lord, we ask now for your almighty hand to be placed upon all of our graduates, family, friends, and faculty here with us today to celebrate new beginnings. As we look into the future, may you lead the class of 2022 to have bright hopes. May you bless our lives from this day forward with success and love. Help us stay true to our dreams and let your blessing follow us as we find new journeys to travel. Give us strength as we face the troubles and temptations of the world and to keep us safe from all the harm and danger. Thank you again for filling our hearts with unconditional love and giving each and every one of us wonderful parents and family members who have loved us and encouraged us to exceed expectations. Thank you for putting every faculty member in our lives to push us academically and be there for our times of need. Lord, in this new chapter that is filled with excitement, anticipation, and fear, let's be comforted by your presence, and let us grow to know you more and strengthen our faith. Let us all of our achievements shine before your glory, and let our hope always remain in you as you carry our burdens in this exciting new chapter. In the Father's name we pray, amen.